Hello guys, today is some tutorial time on the project of Invisible Cloak. So this is the success you see after applying masking, subtraction and addition of the images, and I'll be showing you the real feat behind it and the code behind it, so that you can reach from this level to this level. Okay, so let's dive into the code. Here, as we can see, there are two scripts open, the colorpicker.py and cloak.py. The cloak.py is the main script where we apply all the masking and image processing. Okay, now the import cv2 function is used to import the OpenCV library for image processing into the code, and NumPy is a numerical library for handling the image. As image is a array of pixels, so we are importing the NumPy library as np. So okay, now before writing these two lines of code, you must have NumPy and CV2 pre-installed in your IDE. Next, we come to the third line, which is the camera initialization. Here, the 0, 1, 2 indicates the number of camera. Next, this is a background. Next, we initialize the background and reading the background with cap.read function. What we are basically doing here is, as the as a particular color of the cloak is being detected, the background image is being shown instead of the real feed. So we get a illusion of being invisible. So here we are reading the background image once when the code is being executed. When the code starts to execute, we read the background image, and then we enter the infinite loop. And here we read the current frame with cap.read function, and convert them to HSV format. Okay, now as by default, the CV2 library returns the image captured in BGR format, that is the blue, green, red format. But for image processing and detecting the image, HSV is more preferred over BGR. So we are converting the BGR frame to HSV with the help of color, with the help of this function, and naming it the HSV frame. Okay, so here comes the color detection part. For any particular color detection, we need 6 values for creating a mask with the help of inRange function, so as to detect all the colors in between the two arrays created with the help of 6 values. Two 3D arrays created with the help of these 6 values. Okay, now, so as to create a better accuracy, we are here using 2 masks and adding them to get the blue mask final. And next, we are using the morph open and morph dilate functions so as to remove the noise and smoothen the image. And next, we are using the blue free so as to detect all the colors, to filter out all the colors except blue. Okay, now next comes the back. Here we are basically detecting the blue mask, the color of the blue mask, and masking it and showing the background image as the blue mask is being detected and being stored in the variable back. The present shows all the colors other than the blue mask as the current frame. So the cloaked image is basically the addition of these two, back and present. And here we are showing with the help of IamShow the invisible. The invisible is the title bar of the window open as this script is being executed and showing the cloaked image, which is basically the invisible part. And here we get the if key 27 equals to break, then here basically what we are doing is breaking the loop of infinite loop of while loop with the help of the escape button. As the escape button is being pressed, it releases the camera and destroy all the windows open, and here only one window is being open, which is the invisible. Now coming to the colorpicker.py script, it's not necessary that you have to use only blue and these six values only to get the desired result. You can use any color to any single color to be used as the cloak. These six values are derived from this script. Here we get HSV values. Here basically we create a HSV track bars in a window named HSV, so as we can play around with these six values and create an optimal mask which will detect the color of the cloak. Here we are getting the position of the track bars, and here we are masking, here we are setting the lower and upper value and mask and the mask with the help of inRange function. And here we are showing the mask and masked image and the image which is basically the live feed. And here we are IamShow function shows them side by side in a single window. Here we are getting the position of the track bars and setting it into the image. And here we are using the if key equals to 27 again, so that we can if we press the escape button, the execution stops. And cap.release is for releasing the camera, and cb2.destroy all the windows is for destroying all the windows, which in this case here are two windows open, the HSV window and the horizontal stack window, which includes two pictures side by side. I'll be showing you this this thing. Here I am using the this blue cloak, so it's detecting successfully. So you've got to play with these six values and create a optimal mask. Create an optimal mask for your cloak, for the color of your cloak, and you are ready to go and set those values in these places. And we are ready to go. Okay, now here me signing off. Hope you like the video. The GitHub link is posted down below in the description. so that you can get the code from there. And if you get any error message in you can comment down below so that I can respond to you. So signing off, keep a watch, meet you soon in my next video.